Now, did you see the Sunday program last night? It highlighted an issue that is quite frankly terrifying if you have a child in early childhood education. It was the story of the Vrenata family, whose 22-month-old darling boy, Nehana, choked on a piece of apple at his daycare and is now severely brain damaged as a result.
In a moment, we talk to quality childcare advocate Dr. Sarah Alexander about what needs to change. But first, what we know so far.
It was a heart-wrenching story about a family whose life changed forever after a simple snack of raw-cut apple was fed to kids at a daycare centre in Rotorua. Then the phone call that no parent ever wants to receive.
To say that Nehana had choked, I thought she was going to say, and he'd vomited, but she said, and we're doing CPR, and the ambulance is on its way. So I was like, oh.
The incident wasn't widely reported. It never served as a warning to other centres, and it's now raising more questions about the practices at daycare centres around New Zealand. Well, joining us now is Dr. Sarah Alexander from Child Forum, which promotes quality early childhood education. Dr. Sarah, thank you for joining us. I feel like we're in a very safety-conscious world at the moment. You know, you don't take sugar to kindergarten, so you're watching out for plastic. We're aware of nuts. I would have thought hard fruits would have been high up on the list of safety.
Yes, you'd think so. But it seems to me that within early childhood education, we're kind of behind the times. It is as if there's not a very strong safety culture. The Ministry of Education is not really saying to people, we are going to be enforcing the regulations and you need to be ensuring children's safety.
Because at the moment there are guidelines. Why are they just guidelines and not you will lose your licence if you serve this food which could potentially kill a child?
Well, that's a big question, and that is what we need answers for. The Ministry of Education needs to step up, take responsibility.
Why do you think it's the case?
Well, this has happened before, it's happened now, in 2016, it will happen again. For a wee while, people will go, we need to withdraw this food off our menus at our early childhood centres, but within a short period of time, the case may be forgotten. Food such as apple, raw apple, will go back on the menu again and it will be served to children again. And the Ministry of Education is just reticent, complacent to do anything about it. We need maybe, you know, through the family coming forward and sharing their story on Sunday, I think they have done a magnificent thing.
They were brave, yeah.
Really, really brave. You know, I mean, I take my hat off to them. They just, because it's a case that nothing changes unless families tell their stories. And it shouldn't be the case. The ministry, we need the ministry to be proactive and to be working with our sector, helping providers of early childhood services to understand the regulations and to comply with them.
Sarah, you say this is not a one-off case, but we know that early childhood workers work very hard. They work for reasonably low wages in quite difficult conditions. Are you sure this is not just a horrific accident?
I'm sure it's not just a horrific accident. You know, I've been flooded with emails today from teachers who have told me that they have been asked, required to serve apple, nuts, other food that they know to be dangerous for children. I think it's a problem within our sector that more and more younger children are in early childcare now, whereas in the past we would have, majority would be 3 to 4 year olds. And so menus haven't changed, and the ministry also hasn't updated its licensing criteria that it uses for checking on early childhood services that they are meeting regulations.
Dr. Sarah Alexander, thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thank you so much. You can imagine now parents will be probably going into these childcares and saying, are you serving apple? Are you grating or boiling it? Because that is one recommendation, is that if for under threes, it's at least soft. So some really big issues there that may take some time to resolve, but it does leave us with the big question to clarify, what do you actually do in a choking incident? We ask St John.
If your baby is choking, first thing you're going to do is phone an ambulance or send someone to phone an ambulance. You're then going to sit down and, supporting their head and their neck, lay them across your knees and give 5 quite hard back blows between the shoulder blades, checking each time. Once you've done 5 back blows, you'll turn them over and again, putting them across your knees, you give 5 chest thrusts at armpit line in the middle of the chest. If at any point you notice something in the mouth, you're just going to turn them on their side and let it fall out. And you're going to continue that process until help arrives or they become unconscious or unresponsive. And at that point, you're going to put them on the floor and do CPR. If your toddler or child is choking, the first thing you're going to do is phone for an ambulance. You're then going to ask them to cough if they can cough. If they can't, sit down, pop them on your knee. You're then going to give 5 back blows between the shoulder blades, supporting them across the front of the chest. Quite hard. And checking each time if it's been dislodged. If that doesn't work, you're going to turn them around in front of you, come in under their arms, across their chest, and give 5 chest thrusts with a good squeeze each time. You're going to keep repeating that process until the child goes unresponsive, and then at that point you'd lie them down and start CPR. If you do suspect your baby, toddler or child is choking, please don't hesitate to call us. Phone us straight away. We'd much rather get there and find that everything's okay and you've managed to clear the obstruction.
And for more info on St John First Aid courses, we've put the link on our Facebook page. Terrifying.
Oh, it is. And of course, you don't want it to get to that point. And for me, it seems like quite an easy solution. You can still serve the apple to under threes, but just have it grated or boiled. And I think that would make everyone, including the daycare teachers, feel safer.
Mm-hmm.